Okay then, hello students. So today we are going to learn about Whitworth quick return mechanism. Whitworth quick return mechanism and its acceleration analysis. Acceleration analysis. Okay. According to our previous class, we have completed the velocity analysis in terms of velocity diagram. It was a graphical procedure, and we'll use the same alphabets over here. So this is O, this is A, and here B is on the crank and B dash is on the slotted lever. Okay, and this is C and this is D and this is E. From velocity analysis, we already know a few things that I'm going to write down here. We know. So known values I'm writing here. From velocity analysis diagram, you will know all these values. The values are velocity of B with respect to O, which is crank's velocity, velocity of B dash with respect to A, velocity of C with respect to A, then you will know velocity of C with respect to D, velocity of D with respect to E, and all angular velocities are known. Okay, all omegas are known from the previous video. Now we will make use of that data and find out few things. And you even know a logic which we already we have discussed. The logic is whenever a link is rotating, it will have two components. One is radial and another is tangential. And one more thing, if a slider is sliding on a rotating link, if a slider is sliding on a rotating link, it will be exposed to Coriolis component of acceleration. So these are the points to remember. Done. Now we will draw a tabular column and we will see step by step how to solve this type of problems. So this is a tabular column and we have the first column over here. So this will write the link name. For link name, that column is present. And next column, we will write the magnitude of radial acceleration. For that, this one. And next column, we'll write the direction. We'll draw the direction of the same radial acceleration. Then this is for tangential acceleration magnitude. And the next column is therefore the direction of tangential component of magnitude. And the last column is whatever extra parameters come up, we will put in the last column. Extra parameters means parameters like Coriolis, or it might be pure sliding. For pure sliding, we don't have radial, we don't have tangential, right? So for those things, we will leave the last column. And now we will write what are the different things. This is for link. So link name you have to write here. This is radial acceleration. You have the formula V square by R. And this is direction. And then the next one is tangential acceleration, which is alpha into R. And this is also again direction of that tangential acceleration. And this is miscellaneous, means some other things. So first thing is go to the crank. Crank is OB. Yes, crank is OB. So OB is rotating and it is rotating with constant angular velocity. For example, it is given 120 RPM. It means you have radial acceleration. Yes, radial acceleration definitely is there. And the formula of radial acceleration is V square, means V velocity of B with respect to O square divided by R, means it is OB. OB. From the configuration diagram over here, you should measure the OB and then put it here. VBOC, we know, already I mentioned here, we know the first value is already known, C. So put that value here from the previous video, you will know that value. And now it's the magnitude is known. Then we need to know the direction. How will the direction be? It will be inwards. Radial acceleration always inwards. Inwards means this is the direction in which you can see the radial acceleration. Okay. And then comes the tangential acceleration. Now, do we have tangential acceleration? Since omega is equal to constant, the formula is alpha into R, but alpha is equal to d omega by dt. Since omega is constant, d omega by dt is zero and alpha is zero. If alpha is zero, there is no tangential acceleration, there is no direction also, and there is no miscellaneous also here, means no extra terms. So first column we have completed clearly. So now we are going to draw it on the main figure. See, this is the direction of radial acceleration and it is fixed. Usually it's a long line. Okay, so let's say that this is the line which we got from that magnitude. Okay, using this magnitude you will draw this line, and now you will write few things over here, like fixed point is over here, like O comma A comma E. These are the fixed points. Then now go to the next link. What is the next link now? Next link is, if looking at the sequence, if we see the next link, I can see that is B with respect to B dash. B with respect to B dash. Now when it comes to B with respect to B dash, B dash, see, I will draw here and clearly explain. See, this is A point and this is O point and this is the point on the lever. Okay, just think that B has come a little bit up. B is on the crank itself, right? And B dash is here. Right now in this diagram both are coincident over here, but actual nature is B dash is always on the lever. Sometimes it comes in contact with B. Okay, it means you see that there is a slider and the slider is also rotating, right? The slider is also rotating due to the slotted lever. It means it will have Coriolis component of acceleration. So first you should write Coriolis component of acceleration is formula is 2 into V into omega. I hope you have seen the derivation in the previous videos in the same playlist. So what is this V? This V is about, this V is of slider. So slider means velocity of B with respect to B dash, right? And omega is of what? Omega is of the lever, angular velocity of lever. You can say it is angular velocity of B dash C, or you can see AC or B dash C are same. Okay, it's the same link, right? So B dash C, I told all the angular velocities also are known. Okay, better to write AC because we already have VAC. So VAC is equal to R into omega AC, right? See, how will you find out? VAC is equal to R, means it is AC and it will become omega AC. So omega AC will be VAC divided by AC. Okay, see, like this. So you can find out AC. So it better I will write that it is AC here. Instead of BC, I'm going to write AC for our convenience. So omega AC, or else you can write B dash C also. Now you got the magnitude. Magnitude is known. And where is the direction? So boys, direction, I'll just show it over here and we can erase it again. So direction is, see, whenever the crank is rotating in this manner, see, crank is rotating anti-clockwise and the slider is moving up, as well as even this lever also is rotating anti-clockwise, right? Lever also is rotating anti-clockwise. So now you have to rotate this velocity arrow. Crank is rotating clockwise, right? So lever also is rotating clockwise. So you will rotate this velocity line clockwise 90 degrees. So this is your direction of Coriolis acceleration. Just rotate the velocity in the direction of rotation of the lever. So lever is rotating clockwise. Rotate V also, holding the tail, rotate V clockwise for 90 degrees to find out the direction. Hope that this point is clear. Now I am going to show you exactly how this is going to look. See, so upwards is the direction. So perpendicular to it is, this is the perpendicular, right? And this is the direction of Coriolis acceleration. Put that component in this diagram right now. Right now, put that component in this diagram. So here 90 degrees, right? And it's a small line with 90 degrees. Put it here. Put it here, okay, at point B. Put it at point B. I have not written point B, right? So label it, this is point B. Okay, this is Coriolis component of acceleration. Let's write it A, C. And now after writing Coriolis component of acceleration, B with respect to B dash is even sliding. B with respect to B dash is also sliding. So sliding component also is there, and sliding means it is along the link. Okay, I draw it along the link. So along the link it's sliding. So acceleration, this is the acceleration which you'll get. So also sliding, the direction is shown here. Okay, also sliding, this is the direction shown. So just draw a line, don't mention any arrow right now. Okay, don't mention any arrow right now, just draw a line. Draw a line, and it should pass, it should be here, like after the, at the tail of Coriolis component of acceleration, just draw a line which is perpendicular to Coriolis component. Because see, if it is perpendicular to Coriolis, this all, it is same as the link of the lever, right, parallel to it, because Coriolis is perpendicular to the lever. Okay, just draw perpendicular, and this is your sliding component. Now we have completed B, B dash. Done, B, B dash is completed. Now just end it with this box, and then we'll go to the next link. Now coming to the next link, go to B dash A. B dash A, because see, B dash is here, B dash is here, A is here, means B dash is rotating about A. Remember that B dash is rotating about A. So it will have again two components, B dash A. Just write it down here. One second. I got two arrows here. Okay. So B dash and A, I'll be writing here. So B dash A. B dash is rotating with respect to A, so it will have radial component, and radial component will be what? Will be V B dash A square by B dash A. Do we have B dash A? Yes, B dash A is also here. B A also, B dash A is also here. And you even have in configuration diagram the length, find out radial component. And what is the direction? As A as center, it's rotating, right? A as center, it is rotating. So from B dash towards the center, this is the arrow, this is the direction. Okay, show this direction here. I will just reduce the length. So this is the direction. Is it parallel yet? Little bit. Okay, done. And does it have a tangential component? It might have a tangential component. It has a tangential component, but magnitude is unknown. Okay. Before that, we'll just draw this line also on the main diagram, the radial component, right? So radial component, it should pass through A, because A in B dash and A, we have only A. So let it pass through that A point. Okay. So now we need another component, which is our tangential component. So tangential component is always perpendicular. We don't know the magnitude, but we know that it is perpendicular to link B dash A. So just check. Yes, this is the perpendicular. So mention the direction here, and then take the same arrow, and then you have to move it from here. And it is cutting at some point, right? So this point, wherever it is cutting, that point is your point B dash. Now we got where B dash is. Okay. So now we got where B dash is. That point is your B dash point. So mention it. So this is your B dash. And let me make this a little more neat, since the diagram may look clumsy. I'll remove this line, and I'm going to again add properly till here, wherever they intersected, right? Where did they intersect actually? Yeah, this is the perpendicular. So they intersected somewhere here, right? Let me undo it. Okay, intersection is here. Fine. Okay, leave it. Don't mind about it. We'll go to the next. We got B dash. Well and good. And now we'll go to the next link. What is the next link? Next link is your C point. On the same link, you have point C, right? So about point C now. How to find out point C? I won't use this table right now. I am going to do small calculation at the bottom here and find out. Just see, I can write this equation or not. Capital B dash and capital A divided by capital A capital C is equal to small b dash small a can be found from here, small d dash small a. You can attach this a and this b dash and find out, divided by ac. You will find out this, you want to find out, just cross multiply, you will find out small a small c, and from there you can find out how. See, b dash a and c are on the same line, right? So I'm going to take a straight line now. B dash a and c. So from b dash it should connect a, and c will be somewhere down, right? Somewhere down here. Let's say it is at certain distance. I'm drawing it heavy distance, but it might not. We'll get ac, right? So measure from a, measure the point c and mark it. This is c. This point here I marked it, it is c. Okay, so it is a. A is here, b dash is here, a is here, c is here. B dash is here, a is here, c is here. Same in as in configuration diagram. Okay, so we got point c also. So now we will discuss about point cd. This is cd link, right? Cd link also is in pure rotation. So radial component is v square cd divided by cd. Do we have v square cd? Cd, yeah, cd is here already, known value by v square by cd. So you get the value. And how is the direction of it? The direction of it is upwards. Yes, towards the C. Because see, in C and D, what do we have here? C. So you should check that way. In C and D, what do we have? We have C. So when we have C, it will be in the towards direction, towards the C. You will assume that C is the center of rotation, and this is the direction. Okay, so mention this direction and just length it, check it if it is still parallel. Yes, it is parallel, and mention the length here. Okay, mention the direction here. After this, tangential magnitude is unknown, but we know that it is perpendicular to the link. Okay, direction is known, magnitude is unknown. Same case here, just put it here. Yes, so now first draw in this main acceleration diagram, draw the same thing. See, you know that this is the arrow upward direction, right? So do that, upward direction, radial component. So put the radial component from C, it should pass through C. Yes, this is the radial component passing through C. I don't know where it will actually go, so let's draw it down and up, like above C and below C. Let's draw it. Is it still parallel? Yes, parallel. And above and below you draw it. Okay, and now what do you do is draw the definitely it's going up. One sec, hold on. Okay, let's say that it is going up in this manner. Okay, it's going up. And now you have to draw the tangential component, which is perpendicular. So draw the tangential component, which is perpendicular, right? So some amount of length you take and draw, and don't know if it will go up or down, but let's say that it is, from my experience, I can say that it is going to cut down. Yes. Yeah. Now D is somewhere on that line of tangential component. So now check the velocity of D with respect to E. That is the next step. So D, E. So in DE, there is no radial, there is no tangential, because it is sliding. So the direction is directly, I can say that. Yes. The direction I'm showing on the slider itself. So this is the direction, guys. Direction of motion. So this is the direction. And it is touching E, right? E and D. So through E, E is already present. See, guys, this is the point E, which you can see here. This is the point E. So passing through E, I need to draw a horizontal line which cuts. Passing through E, I need to draw a horizontal line which cuts. Just check if it is horizontal. No, it is not horizontal. Yes. Yes. Now it is horizontal. Now I am passing through E, and E is there. See, I touch that point over there. Wherever it is cutting, that point is your point this point is your point D. Now you got point D. Okay, now with red, whatever I connect with, I'll use the red ink and connect. So that is your acceleration diagram. Okay, see, this first red line is your acceleration, well and good. And from B to A dash, so this is this is the line, just connect it, because these both are components. One is Coriolis, another is along the sliding component. Okay, just connect this from B. Okay, from B, connect it. And then the next line you have to connect is from E also, you have to connect till here. Yeah, already I have connected it with black ink, right? And then another two components. Yeah, this is also main. This is also main diagram, which is the sliding from E we have connected. And even from C is linked to A, so this is also a component, right? And of these two components, I got this component also, right? So these are all in red, whatever I have connected, this is your acceleration diagram. Remaining everything is your components. I'll just mention what are those components so that you won't be confused. So this is sliding acceleration component. Okay, and here you have this is for B dash to A. Yes, radial component. So this is your radial and this is your tangential, right? And here also you have, what is this? This is your radial, right? And this is your tangential. And remaining things, I think everything is clear to you people. I'll just erase few things and clearly write OAE over here so that it's more clear. So this point over here is O comma A comma E, and this point over here is C, and this point over here is B dash. Okay, and this point over here is B, right? And now you can even from this, you can even find out these magnitudes which you already don't know. I think you can see, right? These magnitudes which we don't know, like we don't know what is alpha here, right? So A tangential is equal to alpha into R, right? So A tangential of this will be, you in the diagram, acceleration diagram, measure B dash. Where is B dash A? Yeah, B dash, and see B dash is here, A is here. So measure the distance between them. This is the actual acceleration. But where is the tangential component? See here, this line is the tangential component, right? So measure this tangential component, put the value here, okay? Put the value here. I'm going to clearly write down those things. It's better. Okay. So tangential component of B dash A, tangential component is equal to alpha into R. R is B dash A distance in the configuration diagram. It is this distance, B dash A. Okay. So this is your R value. Fine. I will just write it down here. So, A tangential is equal to alpha into capital B dash A. Cross multiply it, you will get alpha value in radians per second square. You can get alpha value in radians per second square. And sliding also you will get by measuring. See this line, this horizontal line, you can see from E to D. So this is velocity of sliding. Measure it, descale it if you have scaled it, and find out. So this ends the Whitworth quick return motion mechanisms acceleration diagram. Okay.